I would tell you that I love you tonight, but I know that I've got time on my side. Where you going? Why you leaving so soon? Is there somewhere else that's better for you?
Hey YouTube, welcome to my channel, Fitness Finesse with Locks. Welcome back if you are already a subscriber to the channel. If you haven't subscribed and you've seen some videos, make sure you hit that subscribe button. If you're new to my channel, then welcome for the first time. My name is Erica, and I am here to give you an update today on my Sisterlocks. So let's get started. First, I want to give you some background information on my hair. Looks a little bit crazy right now, but I just came home from the gym and I am just a little bit over 4 months of having my Sisterlocks. I got my establishment in September of 2018 and it is now February of 2019. So I'm just over 4 months. So I have to braid and band to go to the gym. That way my ends don't unravel. So this is kind of what it looks like. This is just how I decided to braid it today. You can kind of braid it any way you want to as long as you get all your hair in there. But these are my braids. So while I'm sitting here talking to you, I'm going to also go ahead and take down my hair. Which leads me into one of the first things I want to talk to you about today. I am usually at the gym, as I mentioned before in previous videos. So I have to braid and band all the time. And when I come home from the gym, it will be nice to be able to just leave my hair in these braids and go to sleep, because when I wake up the next morning I will have a fantastic braid out. But unfortunately my hair type does not allow me to do that. My hair will stay wet. I'm a sweater in the gym, so my hair is not soaking wet right now, but it's just a little bit damp, and if I don't take these out tonight it'll stay damp. It will not dry for a long time. So once I take out the braids, it does dry really, really fast. But I do have to take them out. And what I would do is go ahead and spray on with some rose water to freshen them up a little bit. And once they dry, which will probably be in about 30 to 45 minutes, then I can braid them back if I do want to braid out for the next day. But I definitely have to unravel these coming from the gym. So, let's see. I got a list. So today is Tuesday and I just received my retightening on Sunday. Let me talk to you about that. So when I first got my Sisterlocks, my first retie was 4 weeks out. I think I had a second retie, which was also 4 weeks out. And then my optician said, let's do a retie 5 weeks out. And let's do a retie 6 weeks out so I can get a better gauge of how often you're going to need your reties. So prior to Sunday, I had to wait a full 6 weeks to get a retie. Let me tell you, I am not one of those people who don't like fresh reties. I was practically dying to get my hair done. It was a hot mess. Unfortunately, I didn't get to do any videos, but I had so much new growth. It was absolutely ridiculous. So I am certainly not happy with having to wait 6 weeks. But when I did go back, my reties, the first couple reties only took about two hours. But this one took close to 4 hours. It was like three and a half hours. I'm sorry. I can't get my numbers right now. So it took about an extra hour and a half, 3.5 hours going 6 weeks out. And I did have new growth. So my hair grows, but it's not like it grows super duper fast. But it does grow, and she needs to have new growth hair to work with when she does my retie. So she would probably be okay with me getting my reties every 6 weeks, but there were some issues with that for me, which I'm going to explain to you. So we kind of decided that 5 weeks would probably work, just because I need my hair like tightened up. I like it when it's fresh and I can actually see my grid. As you can see, I still do have a grid, but when I was like 5 weeks post retie, oh my God, you couldn't see any of this. It was just like the new growth was real, but it wasn't because my hair was just growing so long. It was just because that new growth here in the scalp, it was just a hot mess. So 5 weeks is where I'm going to be, and I definitely don't mind paying a little bit more money to keep my hair looking a little bit neater. So I know some people say that they either love the fresh reties because they feel, you know, nice and clean with them, but then some people don't like them because you see your scalp a little bit. I don't really feel like I have an issue with seeing my scalp, so I'm definitely going to be one of those people who keep my hair retied as much as possible. Once I get to the point where I can start retying my own hair, which is no time soon, I'll definitely probably retie a lot more than I'm supposed to. So we'll see how that works. Okay, so working out with locks. As I stated, I'm usually at the gym 6 days a week. My hair is usually wet when I leave the gym. So what I do is what I'm doing now. Take my hair down and I start to kind of like finger comb it, going through it, making sure that I kind of loosen up all the locks and straighten them out. So back to that week 5 post retie, I was finger combing the back of my hair and I noticed there were 2 sets of locks that were stuck together. So again, I had new growth because I had to wait almost 6 weeks to get my hair retied. My hair is practically wet every day. I'm braiding and banding every day to go to the gym. And I feel back here and there's 2 sets of locks that are stuck together at the root. I was so nervous. So I hit up my loctician. I'm like, oh my God, what are we going to be able to do? You know, are you going to be able to fix this? You know, she was probably like laughing at me and everything. Because they were 5 weeks post-retie, and I say post-retie, so that means I was, you know, from my last retightening, I was 5 weeks out, going on 6. So they were kind of felt to me like they were weak, because when you need a retie and you have new growth, you can actually feel that new growth, and then you can feel where your lock actually starts. So to me, because there's 2 different textures there, it felt like it was weak hair. I was scared to pull on it or do anything like that to it. When it gets to that point where I have new growth and I can feel the different textures, I'm really, really gentle and soft when I do like my braid and bandings. I make sure that I'm not pulling at my roots at all. Again, because I don't want to mess up anything or cause tension on my scalp that causes any hair loss. So I freaked out and told her, and she suggested that I come in, but we only had like a few days until we were going to meet for my retie anyway. So I was like, no, it's okay, you know, we can just wait till we meet on Sunday. I just want to know if it's something that you can fix. But she wanted to look at it, which of course, because she's a professional, she would definitely take care of me. Tamara Poehler here in Columbus, Ohio, she's awesome. So if you're thinking about getting Sisterlock, she's your go-to, because she would definitely take care of you. So I had a meltdown. I didn't do anything at first to these 2 locks, 2 sets of locks that were stuck together at the root. I could feel the hair intertwined, so it felt like they were growing. I think people call those dragon heads, but they weren't that bad. They were just like tightening from the new growth. So I had a meltdown and I was like, oh my God, is Sisterlock going to be right for me? Because I exercise every day and my hair is wet and it feels loose right now. I don't want to lose any hair and I can't pull on it. It feels fragile. So I'm having this meltdown. I'm telling my husband about it. I go into the bathroom and I'm like, you know, I'm 4 months in, my hair is not actually locked yet. Let's see if I can take these things out. Yep. That's what I thought. So I go in there and I start with my starter locks area. This is where I have my starter locks. So we started back here somewhere. So those are like the oldest, a little bit more than 4 months, maybe like 5 months, maybe six. So I decide to start unraveling one at the end to see if it'll come out. So I didn't have a comb or anything in the house. So I just used like my finger and I start unraveling it at the end and it was coming out. I think, so I was able to loosen that up, just one. I think that I would probably have needed a comb or something really small to get all the way through the lock, because the top is a little bit more different than the bottom. It's not as loose because that's where she does the retightening. So I was able to take it out, but I wasn't stupid. I was like, let me think about it. So I was like, I'm not for sure this is what I want to do. I just know I want to see if it's an option. So shared this with my husband because I really had this meltdown. Like, you know, I don't know if sister locks are right for me and they're growing together and all types of stuff. So, you know, one of the questions he had was, you know, why would you take them out and you spent all that money to get them? Here's my thought on that. Okay, because I've already given the price that I paid for my sister locks in a previous video. You can check that out if you're interested in how much I paid. The price I paid for my sister locks, I've already received a return on my investment. I've had my sister locks for 4 months already. And when you average out how much I paid over 4 months, some people pay so much money on a monthly basis to get like micro braids or quick weaves or sew-ins. So I don't feel like it's a waste of money for me if I decide to not keep my sister locks just because I paid a hefty price to get them installed, because I've already received a return on that investment. I've had my locks for 4 months and my hair has looked fabulous for 4 months, and I've been able to just kind of wake up and do my own thing and not worry about my hair for 4 months. So definitely not concerned about losing any money. I don't feel like I need to keep my sister locks based on the fact that I paid money to get them. So, however, I'll be happy to let you know that I had a talk with my consultant, told her about my meltdown. She thought it was so hilarious. You know, encouraged me to, you know, not give up, and talked about how strong the sister locks actually were. Even though you feel concerned about your hair being weak because you have some new growth, she talked about how strong your hair actually is and that I could kind of just calm down and not have anything to worry about. So I'm all good and I'm back to, you know, bent over thinking that these are not the right things for me. So I love my locks. I have no plans to get rid of them, but just like we do with any type of hairstyle, our natural hair, our permed hair, braided hair, you know, you have your moments. And I definitely had a moment with these locks. So don't feel like you have to say, I got sister locks and I love my locks and I'm never going to get rid of my locks just because you paid all this money. It's just human to, you know, have concerns about things. Okay. Let's see. I think I've taken it all down. So, my hair seems like it's growing a little bit, not like super fast or anything, but, just a little bit. So here is what I'm working with. Let's see. I wrote it down. What else do I have to talk to you about? So styling, I haven't really did any updos or anything different than this freestyle that I have now. Cause again, I'm only a little bit over four months in. I got these installed September 24th and it's February like 5th now. So just trying to see how they do, how they'll lock and everything before I start trying to style. But I do have some updos that I want to do, some really gentle ones where I'm not going to be pulling too much at the root or anything. So hopefully I can show you guys some pictures of those. I won't be doing like any video tutorials or anything, just maybe some pictures of what that looks like once I do that. However, one thing's for certain, based on how I feel about my hair when I need a retightening, is that I won't be doing any hairstyles like updos when I'm in need of a retightening. So I'll probably do any hairstyles like immediately after I get a retie, because to me, that's when my hair feels the strongest. So if you're new to Sisterlocks, or if you've had any issues with your Sisterlocks and you do a lot of pinups and updos, I would encourage you just to do those after your reties and see how that works for you. Let's see. And then I'm gonna do an updo so I can cover some of my grays that I have, because I have, you probably can't see them. But let's see this grid. People always want to talk about the grid. Was there no grid like just a few days ago? It was a hot mess, y'all. It was a hot mess. So one of the things that changed is when I first got my Sisterlocks, I had the part here. And then we changed it to a middle part. And now we kind of just took away the part altogether. So she kind of did it like back. So these things can go any way you want them to go, which is lovely. All right, let's see. Make sure you check me out on Instagram, because I post a lot of my daily photos of my hair there. So it's Miss So For Real. That's my Instagram name. And I think lastly, what I want to talk about is, two more things. One is I'm starting to see like little balls. I don't see any now because she just did it. And first of all, I'm hiding in my closet, you guys. It's about 8:30 at night and everyone's home. The husband's here. The kids are here. So there's no privacy. So I'm hiding in my closet to make this video, because I'm like, it's been like 5 weeks since my last video and I want to get something out to you, but the only way I'm going to have some privacy is coming to hide in this closet. So here I am. So can't see really well because the light is not that great. But some of my locks had like little tiny balls on them. And I was like, is this my lock trying to lock a little bit? Because you know they say they start at the bottom. Okay, is this one of them? Maybe. This little thing. All right, so you probably won't be able to see nothing. Maybe not. It's like a little ball. So I don't know if that's like a tangle or if that's how the locks actually start forming. So we'll see. But I have a couple of them with the same little ball. It's not like a ball, but it's like something. Maybe I'm getting too excited too fast. So we'll see, you guys. And then lastly, what I want to talk to you about is, so I asked my lactician, I said, you know, it doesn't seem like my hair is actually shrinking. From watching the YouTube videos I've seen, a lot of people talked about how they got to a stage in their locks where their hair just kind of shrunk up. And I think some of them were within the 4 months that I'm in, or probably like 2 months in. So I'm like, you know, my hair is not shrinking up yet. So what's going on? Is something wrong? And she kind of talked about how everybody's hair is a little bit different and not everybody's hair shrinks up. So some people's may and some people's may not. So I don't necessarily have to be so concerned that I don't have shrinkage. Because I'm like, well, when's mine going to shrink up so it could then collapse back and, you know, all that stuff. And, you know, she assured me that, you know, everybody's journey is going to be different. So it's good to watch these videos. That's why I make them, to educate you guys, since I do have them. And I still watch videos. I watch Mo's World, Chrissy K, Les Journey with Devaney, so many other people that inspire me to get Sisterlocks and keep me going and give me so much information. I believe one lady, Green Thoughts, not for sure. but I watch Sisterlocks videos almost every day. So just because I'm making them doesn't mean I'm not watching them. So that's what we make them here for, to educate and share our experiences. But everybody's journey is going to be different. So know that if you decide to get Sisterlocks or if you're going through your own journey. I think that's about it. So if you like the video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. If there's something in particular you want to like to ask or something you want to know, leave a comment. And until the next time, peace.